Hi Scorpio, welcome to your important messages from Spirit Reading. This is your girl Mermaid Scales Tarot. Thank you so much for joining me here. So the veil is thin at this time. And for those of you that have Scorpio Sun or very strong Scorpionic energies in your natal chart or progressive chart at this time, this message is particularly for you guys as well. When the veil is thin, this is my favorite time of the year to really connect with spirit. And I wanted to take this opportunity to connect with your spirit guides, your angels, deities that are around you, to give you the messages that you need to hear right now, whether it's a current situation you're facing or what's to come very soon. I hope these messages will provide you with the clarity, insight, healing, and guidance that you're looking for by watching this message. This can impact any aspect of your life, love and romance, career and finances, spiritual evolution, but whatever spirit would like to talk about shall be said. So let's go ahead and get this reading started. I'm first going to use my sound bowl here to clear and set the energy for you guys. So let's go ahead and take a deep breath in. And tune into the energy of Scorpio. Well, that was interesting. I don't know if you guys noticed, but my throat chakra was really acting up. And even like a weird sound kind of came out from it. And I just kind of get the feeling off top from that there's something someone really wants to tell you, or something you've been really wanting to tell someone, but it's been held back. But something about what I'm asking spirit and your spirit guides for, spirit is saying it's not going to be held back anymore. So I wonder if there's going to be opportunity that's going to be said that you're just going to blurt it out, or someone's going to blurt something out to you. That's just a small message for some of you guys out there. Let's go ahead and dive right on in with the tarot. So what is the situation surrounding? What do you want to talk about for my Scorpions? Queen of Wands, Aries energy. I like this. You're getting the confidence. You're feeling powerful. And those of you that are very spiritual, even work with magic, with intention setting, I mean, some of you are just starting to get into it. And those of you who have been in it for a long time, there's going to be success around your manifestations. And I have to say, with this Queen of Wands energy, you are very well admired right now. I wonder, again, with that like throat chakra energy, I do feel, Scorpio, someone has something to say to you. And I do feel this is someone that is romantically interested in you. This is someone that has passion for you. This is someone that feels lightened up when you're around them. They get so happy when they see your text message, your phone call, you asking if you want to hang out. You've been a light in their lives, a breath of fresh air. They find you incredibly sexy as well, too, Scorpio. Some of you look really good in red. Or someone's hair color is red, or you're thinking of dyeing it red. Doesn't really matter. But Scorpio, I do feel that you are in your power now, and this is a very powerful time for you to set those goals, to make those goals happen, to keep your eyes on the prize, to rebuild that confidence in yourself. Tell me more. What is Scorpio seeing from this? Four of Bats, Libra energy. Okay. I kind of wanted to say playtime is over, but it kind of feels almost as if with this Four of Bats, you've been really taking your time to rest. Maybe some of you have been strategizing what your next moves are. But also with the Four of Bats too, someone has been keeping something silent. And they didn't feel like it was the right time. And maybe, Scorpio, if this is a romantic interest, you've been waiting for them to finally say it. With the Queen of Wands, you may have felt like you've been sending all the right signs, all the right messages, have been flirting with them, have been seducing them, yet they still haven't confirmed a lot for you. But I feel with this Four of Imps energy, someone gets a little bit shy around you, Scorpio. Someone is a little bit intimidated by you, and not in a way that they're scared of you, but in a way that you kind of astound them in a lot of ways. So they find it hard to express their feelings for you, to tell you what they really think about you, because they don't want to say the wrong thing. They don't want to mess it up because they know you're a powerful energy. They know that you'll go after what you want, and the thing that rubs you the wrong way, it's out the door. And I think they, for some reason, feel like if they were to mess it up, you wouldn't give them a chance. But for a lot of you, yeah, if it's not so romance related, I do feel anything you've been sleeping on, it's time to wake up and get it going, because this powerful time right now is especially potent. And if you sleep through it, if you don't take the action, you may miss the magic that is so potent to you now that will flow easily. But yeah, I kind of do feel for others of you, if you felt like someone's sleeping on you, that's not so much the case. They're just a little bit intimidated. They're just a little bit nervous, and they don't know. And they're trying to think of how to approach this with you, which is why my throat chakra was being so weird. What does Scorpio not see right now? The Seven of Imps. Ooh, Leo energy. I don't think you see how much influence you really have, how people do look up to you, how people are inspired by you. Whether it's like you're that comeback story, you are just someone that through your actions, you inspire people. And I do feel like you have a lot of admirers. But some of you just, I don't know, maybe you've been focusing on a particular person, you haven't seen that, or you've been doing your own thing for so long that, you know, that wasn't quite your focus. But yeah, I just do feel, Scorpio, that at this moment, at this time, you do have the potential to make something happen and inspire those to be behind you for it. And I do feel like there are a line of people that are ready to be more a part of your life, whether that's in, you know, work and career, whether that's in love and romance. This Queen of Wands energy that you're tapping into or have tapped into now is something that others are inspired by, impressed by, and they definitely want to get to know you more so. And you're the life of the party, I'm kind of sensing. In your own way, you don't need to bring attention to you. You just do it naturally. When you walk in a room, people notice you. You know how you're very charismatic. You're very charming. And people are drawn to that. But I also got to say, for some of you, with this Seven of Wands energy, people do speak very highly of you. And if there's anyone that, you know, is elsewise, they're just a little bit jealous, because you definitely get a lot of attention. You definitely are someone that everyone takes notice of, is the best way to say it. And I think that's something you don't realize or don't see. What's in the recent past, or what has happened in the recent past? Queen of Ghosts. Yeah. This is Cancer energy here. A lot of you guys have been spiritually growing. You have been trusting your intuition, listening, seeing. I mean, some of you guys have been building up your clairvoyance, your claircognizance. I do feel that a lot of you are starting to kind of tap into this intuition, and something has been telling you this is the time for your dreams to happen, for you to take initiative. I do feel with this Queen of Ghosts also, for a lot of you, someone is falling in love with you. Someone cares about you. Someone thinks about you all the time. And I do feel like someone views you as being like, you know, an energy that is almost magical to be around. I'm seeing this mermaid fin that this Queen of Cups has, right? There's just an essence to you that is unique, that is vibrant. And I do feel with this Queen of Ghosts energy, what you've been strongly feeling a pull towards spiritually, emotionally, is something that is about to show the importance of why you've been feeling that way for so long. And those of you that are getting a specific feeling about a specific someone, about, you know, their interest in you, their crush on you, you're absolutely right. And some of you have been relying on your intuition to confirm that for you in the recent past. But what's to come in the near future from all this? Page of Bats. So this is the Page of Swords in traditional tarot. Air energy, Gemini, Libra, Aquarius energy. So where the throat chakra was blocked, it's becoming unblocked. Someone is going for it. Someone has been waiting long enough. And even if you look at the imagery of these cards the way I'm looking at them, this Page of Swords has their eye on the Queen of Wands. This Page of Swords, it may be someone that is younger than you that is interested in you or has like a youthful energy. Someone has been wearing a scarf a lot going out lately, maybe because it's starting to get cold, or maybe that's just whether it's a scarf around the neck, a headscarf. Also, sunglasses. Someone always has a particular pair of sunglasses that they wear anytime they step outside and it's sunny. Looks like Ray-Bans to me. But yeah, I do feel like they are ready and wanting to have this conversation with you, and their own spiritual guides and teams are having them and encouraging them to have this conversation. The timing is perfect here. And if there's something you've been wanting to say, Scorpio, say it. I feel as if this person is ready to hear it. They've been dying to hear it from you, because it would confirm a lot of things that both of you have been feeling, but neither of you have really fully stepped up to say and speak on. Bottom of the deck, the Nine of Bats. Wow, Gemini energy. Someone has been having sleep problems lately, and as a fellow water sign with strong Scorpio energy, I tend to feel this around the moon cycles. So the full moon is coming up on October 28th, and I also feel that you've been feeling this impact of mental energies starting to surface, starting to stretch, to purge out, you know, any worries, any fears that are around, you know, a certain romance, around, if, you know, your own confidence. I feel that has come to light since the solar eclipse on October 14th for some of you guys. But with this Nine of Swords, Scorpio, there's not a lot you should be worrying about, truly. And I do feel with this Nine of Swords energy, even if things didn't happen in the way you thought they would in the past, it wasn't meant to discourage you. It was meant to show you a better path. It was meant to show you the truth about certain people, about certain situations in your life. And I think if you guys have been really worried about a choice to make, or if you did the right thing, or if the changes that have been happening are all things that are punishments against you, absolutely not. And I do feel, Scorpio, even with all this charisma you have, this power that you exude, there's a part of you when you're alone that you get very afraid, but you don't show that to many people. And this fear isn't something that's cowardly. I'm not saying that at all, but almost as if you're afraid if you're going to find the right one, if you're on the right track, did you do everything right? And you put a lot of pressure on yourself that a lot of people don't see. That is unnecessary, Scorpio. So I almost feel like spirit, in a very kind way, is like telling you to snap out of it and to just, anything that you feel intuitively guided to do, you're starting to feel power arise when you're around it, when you're near it. Take that opportunity and stop worrying about how it unfolds, because something positive, with the Queen of Wands being at the dead center of this, is going to happen for you. And the more that you are optimistic, the more that you're confident, the more that you'll be attracting that optimistic, confident energy to come your way. Now, if this is outside of you, again, it could be this Four of Bats person that has been stressing. They feel like they haven't told you the right messages. They're afraid that you're not as into them. They get nervous thinking about if they messed anything up with you. They think about you a lot, let me tell you that. So let's pull some oracle cards to dive deeper into this message here. Tell me more of what you want to tell Scorpio right now. Eternal love. Whoa. Love is love is love, and it transcends physical death. My goodness, this is more, even more serious than I thought, Scorpio. If this is a romance that I'm talking about that you feel deeply resonates with you, this could be your soulmate. This could be, even for some of you guys, a twin flame. And I don't say that often. You may be one of the very few in this lifetime that are experiencing a twin flame journey. And I do feel, even if you've met this person recently or you have yet to come and find this person, you will find them soon. And if even if it's very recent, there's already a strong pull that you haven't felt with someone else. And that strong pull, they feel exactly the same with you. You've had past lives with this person. And, you know, I get this energy that even for some of you, your physical body in the past life was buried next to this person. You have graves and tombstones next to each other from when you lived a different life. Some of you could live by a cemetery and that's confirmation for you. But yeah, this is something that is deep and it's rooted from past life energies. Certain karmas are meant to kind of play out within this lifetime between the two of you. I'm really drawn to these daisies here. And maybe the daisy flower means something to you on a personal level. You've been seeing a lot of daisies recently. But yeah, something's growing. Something's blossoming here that has a lot more power to it than I think you were even aware of, Scorpio. But with the intuitive energy that's been building around it, the emotions that have been building around it, both of you are starting to feel something come at a deeper level. Wow. Tell me more. Tell me more for Scorpio about this message you want to deliver to Scorpio. Treat your body well. Okay, that says exercise, meditate, and massage. So yeah, with the Nine of Bats, some of you guys have been experiencing physical pains, migraines, and maybe it's because of the powerful energy that is downloading to you. It's been taking, you know, a lot for you guys to awaken. And some of you guys are feeling ascension symptoms, okay? And of course, if you feel sick, please go see a doctor. I'm not a medical expert. However, a lot of you, yeah, the kinks in your shoulders, they need to be worked out, and I feel you need to start prioritizing what your body tells you, Scorpio. So a lot of you definitely are claircognizant, and you need to listen to your body, and you need to do what you can to do your stretches, to have your morning routine that relaxes you. But I do feel, even like for some of you, about this romance message that is coming through very strongly, like, I don't know, maybe you've given a massage to this person, they've given you one. Just they feel healed around you, whether a massage happened or not. You help their stress go away. You make them feel safe. You make them feel at home. You make them feel supported. And that's definitely Queen of Cups energy that you may have encountered with them in the recent past. Someone can have a beauty mark right by their eye or around their eyebrow. But I do feel like if some of you with the Page of Swords, you or them, have been finding it difficult to talk about your feelings with one another, or don't know if it's too soon to reveal, like, maybe for some of you, what you've been shown through the physical interaction, through what they've kind of, you know, you call them, they come over and hang out, and that time you've shared has actually shown you a lot more, but I did get it. Someone just needs to hear the verbal confirmation. And I do feel that verbal confirmation is coming. But yeah, for those of you that are experiencing physical ailments, Spirit is encouraging you to do the research to find things that could help alleviate that. And some of you that have been going to the doctor and they say, oh, it's nothing, maybe there's alternative methods for you to try out. Acupuncture, you know, different diets that will help. I would research on that, and Spirit is encouraging you to do so as well. Tell me more about this message you want to give Scorpio. Tell me more about this message that you want to give Scorpio, you would like to give Scorpio. Yes. Okay, I do not pronounce this very well, so I apologize in advance for butchering it. Lugnasad. Lugnasad. I don't know. I'm sorry. Put it in the comments below if you know the correct pronunciation. But prosperity. And look how it's like even with that ring, right? So for those of you, this is a romance reading. Yeah, this person is the one. This person provides promise, potential, growth, harvest, of security, of devotion, of care. I'm getting very strong Virgo energies for some of you guys, whether you have strong Virgo in your chart or you're dealing with someone with strong Virgo in their chart. But I feel with this prosperity here, again, if it's not so romance related, then this is the time to make things happen. The power is now. And relieving those physical ailments that some of you guys are going through will also help the flow of this prosperous energy to come through. Some of you guys need to eat gluten-free. I just feel that very strongly, and gluten is something you've been reactive with, and that will help alleviate some of the physical ailments you've been going through. Okay, tell me more. What else does Scorpio need to know at this time with this message? Someone could wear a gold bracelet or like gold bangles around their arm. Easy does it. Look. Look at that plant growing even through the damn rocks. That's your type of energy, Scorpio. It's amazing. Slow and steady wins the race. This is not a good time to rush. Pay attention to every detail. Careful not to get involved with any get-rich-quick schemes. Okay, so with the Seven of Imps, where I'm saying you inspire a lot of people have their eye on you. Scorpio people are going to try to make these offers to you. It feels like a collaboration. It feels like a work project that may not be best for you, but they need some sort of, delegation off of themselves, but not in a way that's helpful, but in a way that it's just easy for them, for you to do it. Don't be that person, first of all. I think they're going to be proven you're not the one with the Queen of Wands, but in case anyone tries it, remember this. But yeah, I think even with the Four of Bats, if this is romance related, where things have been going a little bit slow, where they've been too nervous and you don't know if what you're feeling is correct, like this person does need some time to open up. This person does need some time to flourish and to understand. And I do feel it's probably because they went through disappointments in the past with love and romance. But they want to make sure it's extra right with you, Scorpio. They don't want to dive right on in ahead for it to not be what they were hoping for. But even with that plant spreading through the rocks, I think this is something both of you are hoping for. But let it take some time. The power, the magic is there now, and that's positive. But let it grow in the natural way it's supposed to. Don't overpressure anything, overdo anything. Just how you are being right now is already catching their attention and their eye. And I think the message you need to hear is going to come from it through your patience, through your understanding. Be careful of scam emails. If you've been getting them a lot, be very careful of links that these emails want you to click on. Don't do it, because I feel like there's scammers around you, Scorpio, okay? People, you know, trying to scam you through the internet particularly. So watch out for that. Now I just like taste mint in my mouth. I wonder if someone just brushed their teeth or chews like spearmint gum as confirmation. Tell me more. Ooh, you cast a spell with your existence. Magic flows brightly and radiantly within you. 15. This is it. This is the Queen of Wands energy you guys are tapping into. Regardless of gender or sex, feminine fire energy is magnetically attracting, letting in the opportunities that you can use to kind of burst out and show everyone what you have. But like I said, even with that mermaid tail with the Queen of Cups, there's a magical energy about you, Scorpio, that this person is completely captivated by. They're intrigued by. You put a spell on them and now they're yours. And I feel with this energy here, it's definitely making them more intrigued and interested. And even if it's been slow for them to open up, don't get it twisted. They still definitely feel very strongly towards you. Like I said, I think their actions prove that more than their words. But I feel with this magical energy here, there's something that you have in the works that it's going to be what you've put into the hopes, the energy, the time. You're right on the dot with it, and to keep going with it, because something successful is the outcome here, especially with prosperity, right? What you want will be yours is what I'm hearing. And those of you that work with deities that are associated with magic, Isis, Freya, Rhiannon, and others that, you know, you work with particularly, they are helping you. They are guiding you, and you feel that powerful energy surge through you when an opportunity presents itself. You act as a vessel for their power in ways. And it's not completely like you lose your free will, but it's part of you is kind of tapping into that energy, that goddess energy, that god energy that a lot of people pick up on. They can't put their finger quite on it, but those of you that work with deities, you definitely channel that magic. All right, let's go ahead and get one more card for my Scorpios. Anything else that Scorpio needs to know right now in this moment for their message? Any last messages for my Scorpions? Ooh, okay, you guys got two cards. So Valiant Courage, and it says, take action with passion, and then Grace and Gratitude. Through gratitude, joy expands. Yeah, I do kind of feel that is going towards the Nine of Swords energy. I feel maybe in the past you guys were a lot more worried, anxious, worried about the future, and there's just a different vibe you're coming into with Queen of Wands of what is meant to be shall be. I'm leaving it in spirit's hands. I'm leaving it in God's hands, and how it will work for me. And in the meantime, I'll be thankful for what I have. And as you guys kind of tap into that, that's where the prosperity is growing. And then with Valiant Courage here, so someone stepping up to the plate. Knight of Wands energy, it's giving me Sagittarius energy as well for some of you with this card here. But I do feel for what you can do, Scorpio, take action on it. What's out of your hands? I feel like it's coming to you. But I do feel this is a powerful time for you guys, and you best use it now, because an opportunity like this, the power and the potential that's here for you guys, it's going to be kind of fleeting if you don't take up on it now. So that's just my advice for a lot of you guys with what I'm feeling all around you. Thank you so, so much, Scorpio, for joining me for this reading. I really hope it resonated with you. I hope it gave you the clarity, insight, healing, guidance that you were looking for by watching this message. And if it has, please let me know. Drop a comment below, hit that like button, and don't forget to subscribe. I love you, Scorpio, very much, and I'll see you next time. Take care, Scorpio.